So, drums will just start.
Snare wasn't on.
There you go.
Thank you.
That was me on not playing 69 three times.
No problem.
We settled in.
Could we hit 30, like, take the sign back to the end, to the, and then the go to the coda?
Yeah.
So you want to take it back, or do you want to start at the sign?
Let's start the sign.
Okay.
And then take the coda.
So start at 35 and take the coda. Right now, you guys know what compression is?
Yeah.
What's compression?
Depends.
Yeah. Right now we've got this, like, blocked all the way through. We never come off of 4th. Not once did it ever leave that all the way through. Yeah. So it's pretty impressive. If you're in the studio and you're putting compression on, you're taking away all the dynamic range, right? But that's what it feels like. So where you guys have anywhere where you have a crescendo, if you want that to be effective, you've got to come down and then give yourself some place to go. Right now, it never comes down, so you just have forte straight through. So it's an effect. And some bands do it. Dojo does it really well. On some days. But you guys can do those dynamics. You just got to concentrate on it. When you see that drop down, that mezzo forte there, it really means mezzo piano. And then give yourself somewhere to go, and you will add a whole other element to this piece. 35?
Yeah. If there's another place you want to get to, where you get?
It's just those dynamics, so I might stop on a few of them.
Okay.
But that's the biggest thing, then. It would probably help to just start it, so just so we can kind of lock in a little bit.
Yeah, that's better. Cool.
35, trumpet pickups. 1, 2, 1.
Thank you.
Good?